I love versatile device for filming videos, and the light from SmallRig can confidently be called one, as it can be used for absolutely different creative ideas, starting from eliminating a person in the frame and ending with object shooting. This video light helps create stunning lighting in photos and videos. In this episode, I will talk about pros and cons of the device, show how I use this video light for my blog, as well as interesting and unusual ways of its application. Friends, hello everyone, this is Alex Yasny. The SmallRig company sent me a video light for review called RC30B. It has a power of 30 watts and is quite lightweight and compact. Thanks to this, we have the opportunity to install it in hard-to-reach place and also take it with us on outdoor shoots. Plus, it can be powered by a power bank, which further expands its capabilities. When I first saw this light, I thought it would only be suitable for use as a backlight. But after studying the instruction and working with it, I realized that it is a more versatile device and I really like it. So, the first way to use it is as the main source of light. That is, with its help we can illuminate the main object in the frame. For example, right now I am illuminated by the SmallRig video light, and the picture turns out to be quite pleasant. Of course, to make the light as soft as possible, it's best to diffuse it. For example, this can be done with the umbrella. We install it into a special holder and get a nice light and shadow pattern on the speaker or another object. But the umbrella takes away a bit of brightness, and in some cases it might not be enough. Pay attention to this. And now you see two pictures, one using SmallRig and umbrella, and the other using the Godox SL 60W video light with a 65cm softbox. The picture with SmallRig doesn't seem bad to me, but at the same time the light is a bit cheaper and it's more versatile than Godox. The second option for users is a backlight. You can see on me such a bright outline here and here. That helps to separate the silhouette from the background and makes the video look more professional. I attach the light above me to the ceiling and its shininess on the back of my head, creating backlighting. Of course, you can attach it in another place, for example, right behind you or somewhere to the side. It all depends on the possibilities of your room. The next option for users is background lighting. We can direct the light onto the wall and create some light spots to diversify our video. By the way, thanks to the lens and the extendable design, we can change the angle of light, scattering, and achieve the desired effects. You can also experiment to place something in front of the light, for example a flower, then you will get an even more interesting pattern. Another option is to use the light for product photography and videography. We can achieve various interesting effects in the frame and create a more creative visual. Note that this light source, when reflected off surface of the phone, allows you to highlight it in an interesting way, creating unusual highlights on the edges and surfaces of objects. It may seem like a small detail, but it is from such details that the overall visual atmosphere in the frame is formed. Also, there are barn doors in the kit. With their help, you can even more control the light beam and get exactly the result you need. The next option is as reflected light. There are solutions when you need to eliminate the scene in the frame, but there is no time to set up bulky equipment, so we can direct this light upward onto the ceiling or onto the wall and reflect the light from them. In this case, we will get good lighting even where there is no possibility or time to install more bulky equipment. In a world where there are a dozen of equipment manufacturers and hundreds of different models, it's easy to get confused and lost. Lamps, microphones, softboxes, tripods, adapters. How to understand what is right for you and where it is profitable to buy it? I have developed a guide for choosing equipment for video filming, which presents different sets of equipment for different tasks and budgets, and also attach links to purchase on Amazon sites. Link to guide will be in the description. The folks at SmallRig care about the environment, so the light comes in a recyclable box, and the package includes the light itself, barn doors, and a power adapter. Please note that the power adapter comes with a Chinese flat plug, so you may need an adapter for a European or US socket. One thing I like is that the power adapter is very compact and lightweight, and the cable length is 3 meters. It wasn't quite enough for the adapter to reach the socket when the light was mounted on the ceiling. Another meter or even two would have been helpful here. If you want to power the light from a power bank, you will need to purchase special cable, which isn't cheap, and it also quite short, only half a meter. The light's body is entirely made of plastic, except for a couple of screws. It all looks sturdy and a good quality, but only prolonged use will tell if it's durable construction. There are only two buttons on body, the power button and the brightness and color temperature adjustment wheel. To switch between them, you need to press the wheel itself. There is also a small display that shows the current brightness and color temperature. Inside there is a fan that is almost inaudible during operation. As far as I understand, it runs at constant speed regardless of the light's temperature. The SmallRig RC30B is a B-color video light, meaning you can adjust the color temperature. The CRI and CCLI quality is 96, which basically means the light produces good and high-quality illumination. The manufacturer claims that the light is equipped with optics that provided even illumination and edge delineation, as well as flicker-free performance, which may be important feature for some users. Of course, the biggest downside is the lack of application control. Since the light is mounted on the ceiling as a backlight for me, I can't reach the power button and it's inconvenient to use a chair every time. I found a solution. I don't press the button, I just plug in the power adapter and the light turns on immediately. Is this a solution? Yes, of course, but how normal it is and whether the video light will be damaged, that's an open question. Another downside is that it's powered not via USB Type-C, but from its own connectors. It would have been convenient to power it from any power adapter with an appropriate power, which most people already have. Besides, then there would be no need for a separate cable for the power bank. By the way, not just any power bank will do. It needs to have an output power of at least 360 watts. The SmallRig company sent me such a battery, which meets this specification. It's a V-mount battery with various ports, USB Type-C, Type-A, DC port, D-Tap and BP ports. I don't even know that the last two are for, but professional will immediately understand what they are for. Why didn't they make it powered by USB Type-C and controllable via an application? I think it's about cost. Without these features, the light fits into the $99 price range, making it a budget-friendly option with decent brightness. Also, perhaps the developers felt that such a device is always at hand and remote controls isn't necessary. Overall, I don't know, guys. Share your views on this situation, write about it in the comments. And if you want to purchase this device, the link will be in the description. Subscribe to the channel to learn more about videography. Dare to create and see you.